Hello everyone. This video is about ARM Core Data Flow Model. Myself Rohini Mergu from Walchand Institute of Technology from E&TC Department, talking about the ARM Core Data Flow Model. The learning outcomes. Learning outcomes of this video. At the end of this video, you will be able to draw and the data flow model of ARM Core processor. You'll be able to illustrate the functional importance of elements in data flow model of ARM Core processor. What is an ARM Core processor? So ARM Core processor follows a RISC architecture. Do you remember what is a RISC architecture? Please recall the video of hardware architecture of embedded system, in which I talked about the two architecture models, RISC and CISC. So CISC is the complex instruction set computer architecture and RISC is the reduced instruction set architecture. So ARM Core processor uses reduced instruction set architecture. It uses a load store architecture. Load store means a load instruction copies data from memory to registers. Data from memory to registers. And what does the store instruction does? Store instruction copy data from registers to memory. So this is the load store architecture. No data processing is directly possible in memory. Hence, for data processing, compulsorily these need to be carried out in registers. The elements of ARM Core processor. What are the different elements? Instruction decoder. For decoding the instructions, there need to be the instruction decoder. A register file, as I said, for computing purpose, for manipulation purposes, we need a register file, or the source need to be a register file. Then sign exchange, it's an hardware, we'll talk about the sign exchange. A barrel shifter, then MAC is a multiply accumulate unit. ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Address register and an incrementer. So these are the different elements of ARM Core processor. The same elements we will see in the diagram. This is the diagram of ARM Core data flow model. As I already talked, the sign exchange hardware, instruction decoder, register file, barrel shifter, MAC, ALU, address register and incrementer. Everywhere there are the flow lines that you can see. These are the buses which are carrying data and instructions. The different processor architectures are available. What are the different processor architectures that you can recall? You recall of the video about the hardware architecture of an embedded system. In that, I talked about the different processor architectures. The basic processor architectures are already I talked, that is RISC and CISC architecture. But beyond that, based on the number of data buses used, based on the data and address buses used, the different architectures are there. Can you recall and write the answer to the question, what are the different processor architectures? You can pause the video for some time and can write the answer to this question. Thank you. I hope you have written the answer. Processor architectures. Based on number of program and data buses used, there are three types of processor architectures. The types are von Neumann architecture, Harvard architecture and Super Harvard architecture. So here the von Neumann architecture is shown in the previous diagram of ARM Core data flow model. Why I can say it's a von Neumann architecture? because the same bus is used for accessing the data and instructions. Whereas we have seen in hardware architecture of an embedded system video that Harvard architecture and super hardware architecture uses the separate buses for accessing data and instructions. Whereas von Neumann architecture uses the same bus for accessing data and instructions. Now let us look at the elements of this ARM core data flow model. Now here we can see the data can be accessed or instructions can be accessed, and from here this block is nothing but the instruction decoder. As the name is instruction decoder, it's decoding the instructions. Means what? The translating the instructions before they are executed. That job is done by instruction decoder. Next, this big block that you can see is nothing but a register file. There is a storage bank of 32 bit registers. There is a storage bank of 32 bit registers, and data processing is carried out in registers. At the start only, as I said, the data processing cannot be directly carried out in memory. Any instruction is not available in which the directly data processing can be carried out in the memory. But for data processing, the data need to be compulsorily in the register file, and that can be done in the register file. So the register bank is provided total 16 registers from R0 to R15. The different modes are there. Based on that, different registers are active. In user mode, the 16 registers are active, that is R0 to R15. So these registers are accessible and can be used for data processing. The different modes such as privileged, non-privileged modes, and the details of that and details of the register banks will be coming in upcoming videos. And this video is only focusing on data flow model. So I will not be talking much about the register file at this stage, but a detailed video of the register file will be coming up next. There is a hardware which is sign extend. What it does? Sign extend means what? So actually, as I said, the registers are holding a 32 bit values, signed or unsigned numbers, signed or unsigned values. So what sign extend is doing is actually the data which is accessed from memory, it can be from of 8 bit or can be of 16 bit numbers, but my register capability of 32 bits. So the conversion is needed from this 8 bit and 16 bit to 32 bit, and that conversion can be done by using sign extend register. And the conversion can be done by using sign extend hardware. MAC, M stands for multiply, AC stand for accumulate, multiply accumulate unit. What it does, this multiply accumulate unit, as you can see, it takes the values from two resistors Rn and Rm. You can see these lines. Takes the values from Rn and Rm using the buses A and B, computes the result. This result is available on this bus, and the data processing instruction will write this result into the destination register RD, and this result is back onto the register file. RD stands for destination register. So multiply accumulate, as the name is there, it is doing the data processing and it computes the results, and the result is accumulated into the register. The one of the important unit, that is ALU. A stands for arithmetic, L is the logic, U is the unit. Arithmetic and logic unit. This arithmetic and logic unit, it does very important job. The load store instruction uses the ALU to generate the address to be held in the address register. As you can see here, there is an address register. This is holding one of the address, and this address will be generated by ALU. So load store instruction use ALU to generate address to be held in address register. The address is broadcast onto the address bus. Register RM can be pre-processed in barrel shifter. This register RM can be pre-processed in barrel shifter, and this barrel shifter and ALU together will calculate a wide range of addresses and wide range of expressions and addresses. Next block comes is the incrementer. As the name is there, increment. See, every time we are not accessing the same address, right? We need to access the different addresses, and for that the updation of address is needed. And update the address register before it read or write the next register value from or to the next sequential location, and that job is done by incrementer. So these are the different elements of data flow model of ARM core. These are the references used. Thank you.